One Love.
Yeah, when you met her at 11, and she was already, I guess, playing with her brother at that point, or before when she was growing up as well?
Oh, yeah. No, they've been proud. They grew up playing in their house in Sendai at their home club. Both of their parents have coached them for years. They have other players playing at their home club in Sendai, but they're beyond that now. Both of their parents are here. Lee Harimoto and Yu Harimoto.
2-1.
Nice start there. Third ball from Lily Zhang.
Not an easy ball to play. Had to follow it up, get the feet under the table there. Training out of Table Tennis America in Northern California, Lily Zhang.
Oh, great start from her.
I don't ever want it to seem like it has anything to do with where I'm born. Miwa Harimoto is the favorite here. No doubt about it. But Lily Zhang is capable and has started, as you mentioned, quite strong.
2-3.
There's a quality to this ball. Miwa Harimoto is quite tall for the Japanese women's team. I think the average height in Japan, at least in recent years for both teams, has moved up quite a bit.
Yeah, 4-2. When you look at... That was an opportunity, wasn't it?
Defense, very awkward ball comes back. Lily Zhang with a bit of a tomahawk chop block sits up near the net. Not an easy ball to play. Sorry, you were saying though?
No, I mean, you're looking at the likes of Mima Ito and Miu Hirano. We're not the tallest in the world.
They're smaller. I think Hina Hayata and Miwa bring it up the head a little bit.
4-3.
And on the men's side as well. I haven't seen as much Mizuki Oikawa or Masataka Morizono recently internationally.
Yeah.
Pretty much everyone on their squad. I mean, Hiroto might be on the smaller side now for the team.
Mahari Yoshimura's fairly tall as well.
So leveled here, Miwa Harimoto makes her way back in. Again, serve and receive crucial. The women's game, speed, backhands, staying close to the table. It's a faster game than the men's game. From reaction time and compact strokes.
5-4.
Well, there's been something about the serve this evening.
Again, at this level, if you're watching and you're new to the sport, the receives are so strong that the players have to serve the ball just at the perfect place, nearly over the net. There's a lot of pressure to be so precise.
5-6.
Well, she makes up for it very quickly. Miwa Harimoto.
Perfect placement again, right into that elbow between the forehand and the backhand, forcing Lily Zhang to make a quick, uncomfortable decision.
7-5.
Well, they keep it pretty fair and balanced here, I guess.
It's that end again.
Are you telling me what I think you're telling me, Shahzad?
Make of it what you will.
I will.
Seven, six.
Nice change of pace here from Lily Zhang. Lily just slowing it down a bit, playing it into the middle. It's a lot to work with on the table. Not everything has to be baseline, and depending on where your opponent is standing will dictate what's more effective to break their rhythm.
Six,
nice
eight.
Down to the serve.
A lot of short rallies here between these two, both fiery so far. Tight serve, low to the net, half long.
Miwa Harimoto there. Has got that momentum for the moment. Six on the last eight.
6-9.
For the longer serve, Lily Zhang. Harimoto now with a 3-point lead.
10,
and now
six.
Four game points for the Japanese player.
11,
well, after a bright
six,
start for Lily Zhang,
game
Miwa Harimoto surging ahead.
One, love.
Adam, we talked in the previous match when Felix Lebrun was up against Sora Matsushima about how exciting times it was for the future of table tennis in the men's game.
Love, two.
In the women's game, is Miwa Harimoto for you the most exciting young prospect we have out there right now in the women's game?
Yeah, at the top of the food chain, yes. There are a handful of others. I mean, Shin Yubin has done incredibly well to be in the top 10. Adriana Diaz feels like a veteran despite being quite young, but in the top 10 now,
love
once again,
three.
At world number 9. Yeah, there are a lot of interesting youngsters. Egypt's Hanagoda, for example, just had a tough one against Chen Tianyi. It's always tough when you face one of the top 5
yeah.
Chinese players.
Exactly.
Or 6, I guess.
Love.
Maybe Chen Xingtong dropped. I have to check the newest. This is what I love about the new world rankings. Talk to me.
I think Chen Tianyi's 8th seed here.
Ah, 8th, okay.
Yeah.
So she's number 6 with Chen Xingtong in front of her, I'm guessing.
Fantastic start here, by the way.
Lily Zhang. Love.
5 unanswered points.
Love, 6.
Whoa, Chen Xingtong had a serious drop in the world rankings. Never mind, Chen Tianyi back in that spot. Interesting, interesting.
Well, this is
6-0.
Fantastic from Lily Zhang.
3-1 in game one for Lily Zhang. And 6-0 here. Bit more encouragement, still not over.
1-6.
Finally gets a first point on the board to Miwa Harimoto. Well, earlier we saw Cho Dae-sung beat Hugo Calderano, where he won at the WTT Feeder Manchester. And Lily Zhang won that event as well on the women's side of things, and that was her first WTT
6-2.
Title after losing 5 previous finals. So once you get that kind of monkey off your back, that really maybe just opens up things for you.
Yeah, not for the monkey. The monkey doesn't even know where to go without a back to ride on.
There'll be someone else.
Yeah.
6-3.
Finding the corner as well here. Miwa Harimoto getting Lily Zhang a step behind the table. It is funny that you point that out in terms of the finals. To get to that many finals of WTT events is impressive enough as it is, but yeah, that's a big step mentally for a player to be able to break that barrier to take the title. Good timing on this one. Nice and early, the backhand smothering it.
What's she doing for you here in this second game? Differently perhaps from the first, Lily Zhang.
Well, I think she's changing up the rhythm quite well. She's not playing for speed. She's not trying to overpower. She's fishing around, keeping it uncomfortable. This shot, for example, Miwa Harimoto handled wonderfully. Lily Zhang gave her an uncomfortable ball, very shallow on the table. And still, Miwa manages to play the ball from out in front, change the timing. The in and out game is not easy, but Miwa's doing it well in that last slow-mo replay.
Eight.
Smart play. Yeah. Lily brings her in and right to the baseline to follow up. Lily's got the power. But again, Japan, the second most decorated and second best prepared of any nation playing table tennis right now in the women's game. Beating them in speed, unlikely to happen. So Lily being clever. Remember, Lily doesn't have a coach on her bench.
That's even more impressive, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
8-5.
Beautiful long push there, loaded with spin. Miwa Harimoto deep to the forehand, closing in. Coach might call a timeout around here, but Lily's out here on her own. She's going to save it after being up 6-0.
Six, eight.
Maybe that momentum is shifting.
Beautiful and Chiquita there for Miwa Harimoto.
Yes, 6 of the last 8 have gone Harimoto's way. Wonder when that timeout might happen.
6-9.
Saves it here.
Yeah.
Slow, spinny, shallow. All the S's just behind the net. Not easy to do. I mean, this is part of the reason we were so impressed with Hina Hayata and Durbin over Wang Yidi. To slow the ball down against someone so aggressive is not easy.
10-6.
And she set herself up with 4 game points here, Lily Jung. I think what we were so impressed as well was how consistently Hina Hayata was managing to do that. Because it's not easy to control yourself. That your natural instinct is to not do that.
And especially with the fastball coming in.
Right.
But serves on her side here, the American dream.
What a rally. Seven. That is the best one of this match so far.
Had it been to take the game, that would have been highlights, no question about it. Probably still will be. Rocket backhands behind the table. Solid defense, but a lot to recover from. Miwa Harimoto stands up above the pressure. Still 3 game points left for Lily Jung.
11,
Lily Jung seven. Takes the second game.
1, love.
Yeah, fantastic second game there for Lily Jung. Let's see what the reaction is here from Miwa Harimoto.
Love, 2.
Controlling the point well there. Sort of setting the pace, not allowing Lily to break the rhythm in that rally.
Love, 3.
Good placement into the middle as well. Remember, right between the forehand and the backhand, you've got a quick decision to make, and you can see that little hesitation. That's courtesy of Miwa Harimoto's perfect placement.
3-1.
Well, that end that Harimoto is on has been the profitable one, shall we say.
It's amazing how fast the last match went.
Yeah.
Just thinking about how quickly they were switching sides.
Another superb rally between these two.
This rally was grittier and more challenging than any rally I've seen this match for a handful of reasons. The last game, sure, they might have had a more spectacular rally, but this had net recoveries, it had change of pace. Both players were holding back a little bit on those final backhands to see who would take the bait first.
1-5.
Yeah, there's a little bit of a chess match going on that one.
And it always is. That's the thing. It's tough to appreciate. But the level of brain power that these pros bring, look how empty that serve was. Light underspin on the first bounce, second bounce almost nothing, and it started to get forward rotation after the second bounce. That was as dead as King Tut. Too soon?
Too soon.
2,
sets
5.
It up with the tomahawk chop block, side spin, and the spank to finish. Lily Jung slaps that ball away. Oh, that one right there gets the passive shot out of Miwa Harimoto.
Similar sort of start to this game that Lily Jung enjoyed in the previous one for Harimoto. Love the way they were sort of battling it out early on in this rally.
The side spin early on, the strawberry from Miwa Harimoto was what set up this tone, this game of hot potato, the touch. But nets, once again, both sides have had them recently.
Seven,
it's
two.
So interesting to see what they're both doing here in this third game with the pace.
Very unusual arcing spin shot. You could see how much it flattened out right off the bounce. All that top spin making it jump out at Miwa.
Let. 7-2. 2-8.
Yeah, we talked about what a good year she's had. She got her first WTT title, Lily Jung. She's won 11 out of 14 matches in 2024. It's a pretty good record. It's a very good record.
That's incredible. Also number one right now in Major League Table Tennis. Her team is looking to advance top.
Three,
look at the timing on this one. Speaking of top, right on top of the bounce, that short stroke forehand. Her timing, her speed is incredible. She's played Chinese Super League, Lily Zhang. Not so many players from
get
the Americas
that, right?
Can say that, yeah. Right.
Eight, four.
Funny, I know actually Japan was knocking at her door trying to get her to play T-League as well. She's played the Indian League, playing France. She's played all over the world.
Yeah.
Cleaning the racket there. You'll see players breathing. A lot of people ask, what should I get to clean my racket? My answer is breath. Buy a bottle of breath.
Eight, five.
Battling back, yeah, this is a lot of similarities to the previous game.
Other than the fact that Lily started off 6-0 up in that game, trailing by, what, she was down 2-8?
Yeah.
Five, nine.
Can feel the frustration when you get a net ball like that and you earn a medium length push, something that comes clearly off the table. Watch this, a little advantage here for Lily. It's a good opportunity for her bread and butter. She loves that backhand, so that's where the frustration comes from. And a fortunate escape there as Miwa Hatemoto celebrates, understandable.
Six,
nine. Nicely done by Lily Zhang, who's now trailing by three.
That forehand flick, one of the toughest shots in the game. Not a lot of wrist there. Has to get the right foot way under the table to move in, get close to the net for it.
Ten, six.
Tomahawk chop block attempted. A difficult shot to do. No shot a la Mian, and few others can do it with incredible consistency, but it's now four game points for a 2-1 lead for the 15-year-old Miwa Hatemoto.
And Miwa Hatemoto then wraps up that third game.
Love one.
What a shot.
Can't ask for much more than that inside the table. Take another look at this. Fast serve to the middle. Miwa Hatemoto like she was expecting it there for days.
One all.
Doesn't matter if you win 17-15 in the fourth or 11-0. You get to the decider.
Yep.
If you're the player down 1-2.
1-2.
Quality opening. Here's Lily Zhang gets a full stroke. Racket head down low. Recognizes early. That's not an easy ball to play. Just barely on the long side of half long.
That leads on pretty far back by then.
And she never really succumbed to lobbing. She stayed on the attack the whole time. This is exhausting. There's one fishing shot quite low, but comes back for the rip. It's not easy to play backhand winners from behind the table.
Happily take that, Lily Zhang, at this stage.
Yeah, this one's irrecoverable. Netball stays super shallow. Miwa quick to react, though. Still almost gets a racket on it. Ball kids staying fresh there. What are you thinking?
What a word. Irrecoverable. Love it.
Thanks. It's the biggest one I know. I don't even know what it means. My mom said it to me once.
Five syllables.
What?
Three, four.
Well, we saw a Japanese player in the previous game show some real fighting spirit. Sora Matsushima to take it to a fifth.
Four,
Lily Chung invoke some of that here.
Again, change of pace. Lily Zhang moving it around quite well, keeping everything unpredictable. The thing is, she's got the firepower when she needs it. So this push is very in between. It's higher to the net, so you think, can I attack? Should I attack? The answer is usually yes, but it depends on positioning. Among many other factors, but here, a finishing forehand factor from Miwa Harimoto.
Was that the biggest factor for you in that second game when she leveled things?
Yeah,
for Lily Zhang.
Uh-huh. Change of pace, keeping it unpredictable, giving something unfamiliar, a little awkward here and there.
Five.
But this
six.
One's
she
all speed.
Quickening it up too.
Yeah, opening backhand. Jessie Fun, if you follow her on Instagram, a lot of fun, but in this moment, a lot of pressure. You might feel like you're out there on court.
Only a point in it here.
Seven, five.
This is big for me. That point right there set a tone. And I say that because Miwa Harimoto, after the response, this shot right here feels like she took control, the driver's seat. Lily Zhang using the length of the table, varying it. That last shot a bit more shallow. The one before right to the baseline, constantly changing the timing.
Yeah, she's done it pretty well today, Lily Zhang. Leads by two.
Seven, six.
Ooh, the faintest of edges. Wow.
Oh, how frustrating for Lily Zhang. Played well in that rally.
I just want to see it. Okay, from that camera angle, it was a little bit more clear, but I heard nothing when it happened.
Yeah, tough.
Seven.
Get what she wanted on that. Lily Zhang, all square here.
I feel like Lily Zhang has a few IOUs in the TTKB, Table Tennis Karma Bank.
Time out. Eight, seven.
Lily just having a word with herself here as Miwa Harimoto goes in front. Three away from taking this match.
Seven,
not the first time we've seen that long push cause Lily Zhang to have to rock back, lean back, and try to lift, and still so much backspin on it that it comes back into the net.
Seven, ten.
Three match points for Miwa Harimoto.
Stroke so good. Full swing, right to the corner, recovers and ready. Second serve here for Lily Zhang with her back against the ropes.
11-7.
Miwa Harimoto, it's all about that timeout, Adam.